All right, here we are again. I tried two times to upload on YouTube. My system's slow, right? So now it's starting to go out like after 8 minutes. But at the same time, I'm thinking to myself, oh, I'm getting pirated. But Mother Nature is causing it. See, there's the blame. I can't blame and say, oh, the pirates did it. I say, oh, Mother Nature. Mother Nature did it. So here's take number three. All right? Now, I gave the international military an order today. Yeah. And I got the banker to sign the piece of paper that says she just ordered my trust checks. And I told, and I wrote them a letter, CID a letter, who's just the ones who carry the gun, backed by the international military. That's our connection. I said, this is my way of writing a trust check to access my trust account. Here's my regular bank check. At the top, it says my name printed, Grantor. I wrote in with pen, Grantor. I signed at the bottom, just like the check, and I said, trustee. I'm the one that decides who gets distributed and when. Not only am I the backing, I'm the grantor, I'm the backing of all the credit for that bond. I decide when it's going to get distributed and who it's going to get distributed to. And it's going to be to myself. And on the back, I endorsed it as trustee or as beneficiary. Yeah, no. And here. Here's the order that I gave criminal investigation, international military. They're the ones with the gun, remember. This is the general of the military right here. IRS, criminal investigation, CID. I'm the king. We're the king. The international military will not do anything unless the king tells them to do something. See what I'm saying? All right. To the IRS, criminal investigation department, Friday, 2/13. February the 13th, 2015 at 12:24 p.m. from me. Dear sir or ma'am, for the sake of honor and all that I have endured for the cause of trust access, please cause the appearance of dishonor of the public bank account for me, such and such name. The copy of the check is my way of writing a trust promissory note. The enclosed check with the branch manager's acknowledged pen and time pen stamped has all the essential account numbers. Because I had her time stamp it too, with her time and with a date, put her name. She gave me a card and I made a copy of the card, put it on the letter. I would also like at the highest level to cause all my check writing for products and services to be automatically honored through my shared lien on the birth certificate application bond from which all paper money and credit are funded. Please additionally provide my current ATM bank card corresponding to the above mentioned account to be honored as bond access too, so that I have the option of easy, quick ATM card purchases and cash for such things that can only be purchased with cash until such a time as cash is phased out. Please send a response letter of confirmation to all the above orders, and then my bank account. And then in the middle, I put, thank you, Russell, AR, capitalized name. P.S. If you need, move all accounts to the private side, connected with a private ATM card, and issue to me such such name. So. And I just happened to have a little flyer in the mail, a little note. It said, Power to pay your way. Feels good, doesn't it? Now put that power to work. And it just happened to be like a little piece of paper with some extra writing on it, an advertisement from a letter I got in the mail. I would just look for something quick to write on, because all of a sudden the energy came up on me to write a little letter to the banker. So, there's a picture of my Oregon State driver's license in the back of it. And on the back of my driver's license, I wrote on there, Oregon UCC shirts, number, lean number, da-da-da-da, with a $1 stamp, stamp of Zeus, and my signature diagonally across it. And then NationalRepublicRegistry.com, where my affidavits, my commercial security agreement, and my commercial lien are posted. That's one of the places. It's also posted on my Facebook. So I put on my Facebook all the trust checks that I wrote that have been dishonored, and I put my Facebook website on the check that I wrote too. So, yeah. So if you get dishonored, put in your lien, you're claiming your lien, become a secure creditor, whatever you want to call it, you know, do your affidavit paperwork, you know, basically rebut the assumption, and, you know, use the templates if you need and whatnot that you learn from Solutions of Commerce. Just type that into YouTube. Learn from Winston Shrout. You know, order some seminars and DVDs and all that stuff from him. You can't afford it, just call his office and tell him you can only afford so much. And they'll work with you. But, yeah. So, you know, done my thing, man. My affidavits are on the record. I know what those things stand for. I understand them completely. But the international military enchilada came together pretty good today. And I was just doing everything by instinct, impulse. But I had months and months and months to think and wait. Just wait for the right idea to come and everything. So, telling you, man, all these videos that I was making, you know, about this whole check situation, I says, I knew it. I just kept on it, man. I know it's going to work. I don't exactly know how it's going to work sometimes, because it's kind of hard to predict the future right now, but until I get better at it. But, hey, I kept on it, man. I kept on it. Shit. I finally realized today, man, I gave the international military an order. And I was all done through impulse and instinct and VEDA. And I didn't realize until after it was done. I thought about it. I said, holy crap. I just gave that CID is the our international representative. International military representative. Because they carry the guns, man. And if they need, they're called national military. You know, they'll use the cops and the sheriff first and the federal marshal, but they need the international military because the bank that I use is an international bank. I think it's international. It's a popular bank. I'm not going to say their name, though. I'm not here to run people in the ground and all that. But it's a strong bank in the United States. Just put it that way. You know, I ain't here to cut off people's heads. I ain't King David. That was the evolution of mankind. Back then, they cut people's heads off. That's why he cut the giant's head off. But his son Solomon brought peace and trade, rehabilitation. We don't cut people's heads off no more. We ain't out to make them walk the plank and get eaten by sharks. We're here to rehabilitate them. And if they've done some things that are really illegal, according to their own standards and legal codes, well, yeah, they will face prison and rehabilitation in prison. And they will be given all the materials they will need to learn private maritime law. In fact, they will have the option to go to courses. We will give them classes in private military maritime law while they're in jail. But if they did some real bad things, like cause people to die, I think it's only fair that they should be... What do you think? Put to death also? Yeah. You You think so? Each case tried is going to be tried individually for motive and intention. Thorough investigations, man. Everyone's going to get a fair shake trial. That's just the way it has to be. Because we're still in the prison system. So we have to utilize that prison system for what it is. Once everybody's been tried and everybody's been rehabbed, and then everybody's going to move on to the next shift. And there's going to be some quick rehab recoveries going on here. Because once they get a load of me, and I get on the stage and I start presenting information about how this earth actually works, they're going to start to see the picture. And they're going to be like, oh, shit. Damn. Fuck. I didn't realize. I thought this was the way to be. I thought the strong were supposed to step on the weak. Because remember, it's all about motive. Some people out there actually think that being strong is a good thing. And that you're supposed to kill the weak and root them out. Because they look at nature and they see nature and say, well, God, it's always the strong animals that kill the weak animals for the sake of the flourishing of the populations. That's not the way it's supposed to be. We rise above the animal brain. We got the most high. We're here to help the weak, to build them up to the same strength level. We ain't here to pound them down. But some people don't know that, you see? So that's why we have to weigh motive. And you can tell a person's heart just by the expressions on their face, and you get a sense for it. And with all the technology that we have from all the extra sensitive people on the earth that can see auras, and they can tell what they're thinking. And not only that, we can hook them up to devices, secret technology that reveal in their mind what their thoughts are, and it'll print it out on paper. You can't hide anymore. So you might as well tell the truth. Because then we'll just catch you in a lie. Because we already got the technology that says what your brain actually is. And what it said. And what its motive was. It's all being been recorded. And it's still all being recorded in the highest satellites. Monitored on a big giant mainframe computer. All 7 billion of us on the planet. Yeah, Judgment Day is here. This is what the Bible talked about when it's Judgment Day. And because I put the military order in, I had to do it. Because of my bloodline. I come from the bloodline of King David, tribe of Judah. And I'm native of the land of America. And if you know anything about America, as America goes, so goes the rest of the world. The Iroquois were the private side of the Cherokee. And they were not defeated. The colonists went into peace treaty with the Iroquois, and then later on, the generations of their children broke the peace treaty because Mother Nature wanted to have them come into and get driver's licenses into the system to get that birth certificate application bond so later the generations can come back and reclaim the land as the original natives of New York. And you know anything about New York? New York's the capital of the whole world. So I'm the king. It's in the blood. And you can check my bloodlines. I rule the earth. From the line of King David to Solomon. It's me. So I'm the one that had to put the claim of lien in to kickstart this whole mind shift thing into action. And I was the one who had to give the military an order for a full-blown investigation. Because if the king is dishonored by the thugs, everybody in the kingdom gets the benefit from the king's investigation. So, welcome aboard. But you still want to do your share, put in your claim of lien, security agreement and your claim of lien, do some studies so you understand what it is, then write you some trust checks on your bank accounts. And when they get dishonored, you get the banker to show that they dishonored you. And if you have to, send it registered mail to the banker and say, hey, and I want this thing credited to my account, the birth certificate application bond. And if they say no, well, then you send that registered whatever to the CID. Send all the copies to the international military. They hold the gun. You tell them you've been dishonored. And you want your ATM access. Baby. You got to give the military their orders. But if you can just get the banker to say, okay, I'll put my name on it, I'll timestamp it and everything. Here's my card. And she did that for me. It was easy for me. I didn't have to pull her shoe. I was just peaceful and friendly with her. I just said, could you write me something that says that you're not going to, you know, accept that I was here and you're not going to accept this and you've seen this? And she says, yeah. Shit. Simple. That's all it took. I didn't have to send her no registered mail and everything. I didn't have to get into a fight with her. I didn't have to raise my voice. I was friendly. And she was wearing the color Santa Claus this morning. Red and white and black. Yeah. And when I pulled in the parking lot for the second time, because first time I went there at 10 o'clock, she says, well, could you come back at 11 because I got a meeting. I says, all right. I came back at 11. She's right there in the parking lot waiting for me in her car. And I would just by instinct, where am I going to park? And as soon as I got done parking, I realized I parked. She was here and I parked right there. We were, it's just as though we could have just went side to side and had a talk. And I didn't even realize I parked right in front of her. It was all instinct and impulse. I was like, I parked and boom, I saw her in the car. I said, damn. She is right there. I get out of the car. We walk in the bank together. I hold the door open for her. She holds the door open for me. There was popcorn on the counter. And one of the customers came in. And he says, where's the movie? And I says, this is the movie. Everything's being recorded in satellite. I explained to him a little bit how the earth works. And he says, I went to Vietnam. I hope there ain't no more action. I says, nope, war's going to end. War is coming to an end, brother. And he was kind of shaken, kind of taken back by what I had to say. You know, he's like, oh, shit. I didn't know what to do. But, yeah. So, let me get this on the record.